Hi friends, in the early tutorial of ezTalks, I have told you about how to schedule a webinar on ezTalks. Fine, and here is the scheduled webinar which I have scheduled. And if I wish to start on the webinar, so I will just click on start and it will ask for me to open the webinar on the application of ezTalks. So here is the webinar opening. What you can do, you can share the registration link in advance to the participants whom you want to attend the webinar, and they will attend simultaneously whenever they get registered and you come in your webinar. So this is asking for the cloud recording, as in the free account it is not allowed. So I am closing it up, and it is asking for computer audio. I will be joining through my computer audio itself. So this is the webinar page, as you can see, and here this session has been started. You can see the options here, like if this is my video is off, my audio is on. As a speaker, here the participant, as only I am present, so one participant is showing. You can share the file and the documents through this share button. You can go through chat option, the record, if this has to be recorded, the breakout rooms are there, and there are the more options. So I am just clicking one by one and show you. I am clicking the camera on, so you can see here is my video on, fine, and here audio is on. Participant, if I click it, you can see as my name is only here, as I am the host. If I want to share any file, you can share your desktop. Suppose if I want to share, you can see my screen is coming. So if I want to share, the screen is visible, will be visible to all the participants. Suppose whatever I am doing here, so this is the presentation, this is my box coming, fine. So if I want to share, I can share it, and if I want to stop share, I can stop share. If I want to allow the annotation to my participant, I can. This is having the mouse and keyboard control of the other participant. If I wish my co-instructor should use my presentation or move my presentation, I can give her or him the control of my keyboard and mouse. I can pause the sharing, I can stop the sharing. So I am stop my sharing. Later you can see if you want to share the whiteboard, here is the option of whiteboard. So as in the earlier many series of very webinars or many tools, I have shown you that the option of whiteboard is very cool option. Like you want to type any text over here, you want to use the highlighter or draw something, the thickness can be changed, fine. If in the present, in case of the presentation, if you want to change the color of the highlighter, if you want to use the pencil too, then also you can use the pencil. If you want to select something, then you can. If you want to erase something, you can erase. Right, so these are the some of the options of, you can change the font size of the text, fine. You can change the width and the dotted lines of the highlighter. So these are some features of the whiteboard, fine. So here are the features. If I want to allow the participants to annotate, they can also annotate. I'm stop sharing my whiteboard. Now to come for the option of chat. So if I want to message to anybody in my classroom, and here the special features of smileys too, in other tools, some of the tools, the options of smileys are not there. So this is a cool one. You can send the messages to the participants. You can record, and again the local recording and the cloud recording options are available. You can have the breakout rooms option. If you want to have more sessions, separate sessions for the webinars. If you go to the webinar information from more, you can see here is the link, and by sharing this link and copy the webinar information, you can allow your participant to get into your webinar. You can see the settings over here. Settings agenda, citizen settings are there. Whenever I start up the computer, you can automatically, you can check in that. You can change the language and the server timings and the time, which will help you to allow the participant to see your webinar timings. You can check the webinar things, the audio video status, how they are working. You can check out that. Fine. You can change the settings for the message. These two one, like play sound is allowed or the floating notification. Whenever someone give a chat message, it will float around here somewhere. So last option is the local recording. The local recording will be done in the automatically by default folder created by the application only, and you can change the folder. Some automatically recording will be done in the at the local computer from which you are doing your presentation. So these are some of the basic settings we can change by going to the more option. And for help, like, you can go to the help option, and it will that will take to you to the server, and in the forums you can ask for help. So this is the option of more option for changing the settings. So this is the platform of ezTalks, and you can definitely use it. It is very easy to use, and it's a good platform. Thanks, and keep using these platforms for your virtual teaching and learning. Thank you.